there's an agenda in place. Secret because agenda. What's happening is these corporations are getting bigger and bigger.
But that's their economy that they like are like leading. So wouldn't you think that they want to
because they can afford the what I'm saying is like the big corporations, Walmart, Coca-Cola,
Amazon.
What the fuck, Target. That's who they want us working for because they're going to be able to make it through this storm.
Yeah, because the they supply and demand.
The people who aren't going to be able to make it through this storm are the small jobs. Business yep. owners because they can't make it. People. And what happens is they lose everything. So they have to submit and go work at fucking Target and work for Walmart and work for Amazon and work and that's the only jobs that are going to be available. Like the whole $15 minimum wage yep. thing. They're the only ones that can handle that kind of hit on the economy because what comes with that is all the prices going up.
Yep.
And the small business owners, they can't afford to regulate. They're not going to be able to afford the competition.
Right.
They're going to have to charge fucking double than what Target's going to charge for
exactly.
that.
Exactly.
Because they can handle the labor tick.
That's crazy, bro.
You know? And we're going to have to submit to them. They want us to where we don't own anything. They own it all, and we borrow it, and we going to be happy about that.
Yeah, at the end of the year, we got to pay back to them.
Well, yeah.
For borrowing their...
They just... Yeah. Well, yeah, they're giving it like the house. You're not going to own your house. You're not going to own your car. You're not going to own anything. You're going to work. They're going to collect the money, and they're going to distribute it and give you what they think that you deserve.
Wait a minute.
They feel like you need to be you.
Back to a conspiracy, since we're talking about this subject. Fast forward another 10, 15, maybe 20 years. That chip.
Without making a face.
I feel like there will be something.
The RFID chip?
It might not be the chip that's an implant. But it will be some form of identification that...
Did you...
You know...
Yeah, I mean, I've showed... I've
that's going to show your vaccination already. Records?
I showed this you already, know? But since you bringing that up, I'm going to have to show... I'll show you. You ready for this one?
I'm ready.
This is Zoe. Just like you, she uses lots of different cards and IDs to get through her day. What if all Zoe needed... was herself. Introducing Amazon One, a free service that lets you use your palm to quickly pay for things, gain access, earn rewards, and more. Let's say you're grabbing your favorite coffee beverage, or heading into the office, or checking out. Just hover your palm and you're on your way. It's as easy as that. Sign up is free and takes less than a minute. All you need is a credit card, your phone number, and your palm. That's it. Since your palm is unique and can't be lost or misplaced, you can get things done quickly and securely. And with more experiences on the way, Amazon One will help you get even more done, simply by being you. Now, Zoe has more time to do what she loves, indoor skydiving. Enter, identify, and pay with Amazon One.
So do you get what we're talking about? You know, you're talking about the chip. Yeah. Right?
And that's crazy because, like, as you was playing the video, I didn't realize that was the video.
Would you like to be able to pay with a gesture of your hands, just like a Jedi trick?
See what I'm saying? Cool. Which it was an ad, but I thought it was like a YouTube paid ad. Like, I didn't think that was
no, that was the actual video.
Yeah, and it kind of tripped me out, like, as I was watching it, and it scanned the palm of the hand.
Right. So they're saying, they're trying to tell you, the way they're selling it is they're selling it to you as, oh, you know... Notice for one, it's in a cartoon.
Yeah.
So a cartoon right out the gate makes you feel comfortable. You know, it's
attracts
it's
safe. Everybody. It's a cartoon, all ages.
Right? And then with they're telling you about how they're gonna consolidate all your credit cards, mm-hmm. all your information, and put it in one little thing on you know off a palm scan.
So what stops me right there from chopping your hand off? And go and use your palm for any purchase.
Yeah, I mean that, but at the same time, that is another version of the chip because Amazon can just cut it off.
I'm gonna have to go back and watch it again. Now
you wanna watch it again?
Did they say that they scan like the
Here, I'm gonna let him listen because he never heard it. Here, we're gonna watch it again.
Put that on. Oh, okay. You like, all right. You see how whenever she was advertising it, she says that your palm is unique, meaning that everybody has a different pattern on the palm of the hand. So it's like an identification, which is like a social security number, which is like a chip, because everybody's chip would be different and it would be, you know, for that one person. So like, if your chip's for you, I couldn't put your chip in my, you know what I'm saying? Because...
Right, so basically, yeah, so it is an RFID chip in a sense. I don't need to inject you with one. You already got one on your hand. You already got something that's different than anything else on anybody's anybody's hand on the planet, your palm. So it's a it's kind of like tricking you into getting it.
How would it know that that's your palm if it never had any other technology to scan your palm and be like, all right, that's you? You see what I'm saying?
Well, you probably have to scan your palm onto your phone or whatever. You know what I'm saying? But what they're going to do is they're going to take you all your information and consolidate it into your palm to where you don't – everything is
– right. As long as you have your hand,
that's what's crazy about like this whole pandemic thing is they're able to say that you know you don't have to touch, you know, there's no germs, you just put your hand. Little things like that.
Why are we living in a day and age like this though?
Hey, where's your sense of adventure? Take a fucking chance, will you?
Because
man, I grew up playing outside barefooted, you know what I'm saying?
Right. I'm telling you, we're going to have to live in the woods eventually. People are going to have to make a decision. Either they're going to have
to... This is making our immune systems weaker and weaker so we can get, like, just... Like, if our immune system keeps getting weaker and weaker, a regular flu would kill you. Just it'll be a pandemic again like the flu was back in the, you know...
Let's put it this way. People fought for the things that's in that Constitution, in that Bill of Rights, for us to have civil liberties, to just give that away.
It's just one more way of reducing your liberty and reminding you that they can fuck with you anytime they want.
I mean, just do your homework. Look around at other countries and see what happened when they gave that away. People don't realize what's going to happen. Once you give the government power, you either not getting it back at all or you're never going to get it back the way you had it before you gave it to them.
It'll
never be like it was. And that's what's up, dude. You have to be careful about how we play this game here. And they got you afraid of a boogeyman.
Seeing all that and like you're scared to come out your house because they're telling you this, but when you look outside your door, it's not like that.
Right.
They're only going to show you what's worse, like on the news, and they don't ever talk about what's good on the news.
They've gotten
about what's
caught.
Bad.
One of the big dogs at CNN got caught. There's a guy. His name's James O'Keefe. He runs this company called Project Veritas.
Twitter permanently suspended his account after he exposed hypocrisy and fraud at CNN.
Project Veritas, a very controversial...
Focus was to get Trump out of office, right? Without saying it, that's what it was, right? So our next thing is going to be for climate change awareness.
Do you think it's going to be just like a lot of like fear, like climate?
Yeah, fear sells.
No one ever says those things out loud, but it's obvious.
For years, we've heard that CNN is the most trusted name in news, but a CNN director is on tape telling us that their propaganda, helping a certain political candidate, employees admitting what we've always known to be true.
Trump his hand was shaking or whatever like that. We brought in like so many medical people to like all tell a story that like it was all speculation. But he was like neurological damage, like that he was losing it, he's unfit to, you know, whatever. We were creating a story there that we didn't know anything about, you know.
I think there's just like a COVID fatigue, so like whenever a new story comes up, they're gonna latch onto it. They've already announced inner office that once the public will be open to it, we're gonna start focusing mainly on climate. It's going to be our focus. Our focus was to get Trump out of office, right? Without saying it, that's what it was, right? So our next thing is going to be for climate change awareness.
Who decides that?
Head of the network, like, just...
Who's that? Is that Zucker?
Zucker, yeah.
Climate change is going to be the next COVID thing for CNN. We're gonna hone in.
Our focus was to get Trump out of office, right? Without saying it, that's what it was.
And that's the question, Mr. Zucker. Why is it so important to hide the truth of what you're really trying to do?
And what he does is he actually gets people to spy on people that he thinks that are doing some fucked up shit. And he catches them.
Why he ain't spying on fucking Epstein? You know what I'm saying?
What he did was... Well, check this out. So what he did was he got this guy that he knows that was one of the big wigs at CNN, got this chick to hit on this dude on Tinder or whatever.
On purpose, huh?
And got right. And this chick was messing with this dude on Tinder and got him to admit that the reason why they intentionally downplay everything that Biden does that's fucked up and and over-dramatize everything that Trump does. They admitted that they fake every...
It was like, all right, I'm going to adjust the media to see...
This chick asked, like, this. He wanted some pussy, you know.
Yeah.
She basically waved a magic wand in front of him.
Wet-ass pussy. Make that pull-out game weak.
And he admitted to what they were looking for. So what I'm saying is this dude takes this information and puts it out to the public. So they got caught. CNN got caught as liars already by saying definitely what they said. So they admitted to propaganda what happened was, since he released that, instead of going after CNN, Twitter canceled him, cut him off.
Yeah, for like a week, and then he was back on his bullshit as soon as the day came up.
Yeah, no, he's kicked off again.
Again?
He's done. Yeah, he's done.
Oh,
he's,
man.
So he's suing him.
See, like, all right, I understand, yeah. Having like, I understand. All right, you are the president at this time, which was Trump.
I could stand in the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody, and I wouldn't lose any voters, okay?
But getting on social media, which another way that I know that he can get in touch with his people, like not people as in like, you know, close to him, but like us, like I guess, or anybody who supported Trump, mm-hmm. I guess getting in touch with his people, you know, like he would post on that shit daily and.
Every day you're waking up and you're getting these tweets and you just don't know.
Just well, right, he was oddest, able to stay like, in contact. Crazy as shit, though. But at the same time, I felt like it was a good platform for him because, you know, like...
Well, it's a platform.
Instead of him being on live TV in front of millions, right. He can...
There's no... He's his direct...
Right, it's him.
Direct contact
it's
with his
like
people.
It's not like something he's reading or went
right.
over.
Right, he doesn't have
times.
To get a camera in front of his face and that and they take...
And they
that
didn't
recording,
like
and they put
like
whatever
that.
They want out. Yeah, like,
they
no.
They don't want
was,
you to have
no,
your
sure.
freedom of speech. They want you to be control of, you know what I'm saying? Like, I look at it like this. The president does not run the world. He's just the face of America. He's just the face of, you know.
Well, what's coming.
The spokesman.
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by, go, you know the thing.
Coming
it don't make no law.
They're trying to push the social score.
A large and increasing number of the world's investors are integrating environmental, social and governance, or ESG, to understand risks and opportunities.
It is critical, and I'll give that to you in just a minute. Let me just go through what is happening on one part of the Great Reset. Banks have always been the helper for capitalism. But you have to understand, capitalism is changing. It's no longer shareholder capitalism. It is stakeholder capitalism. And the stakeholders are the government, the companies, the CEOs, and you. You're a stakeholder, but you're not part of any of the decisions. Your government at the federal level is making all of the decisions in your name. That is exactly how they describe it. What? We're not leaving people out. The government is doing the decision, and it's an elected government. Uh-huh. And all of the people who are the stakeholder deciders, they're all going to be wildly wealthy. This is the biggest heist. and the biggest cage ever constructed in global history. Now, earlier this week, I told you that a friend of mine sent me something that they got from Merrill Lynch. Well, that friend of mine is Justin Haskins. And
thank you, Glenn.
You're welcome.
I'm glad to be your friend.
I love that. So tell me about what they got from Merrill Lynch.
Right. A coworker of mine logs into his Merrill Lynch account. Not a rich guy, just a regular guy. Got his 401k and Merrill Lynch, logs into his Merrill Lynch account, and up pops this really friendly, amazing notice that you've got your very own ESG score, mm-hmm. your environment, social, and governance score. Scores in all three categories and an overall score. And unfortunately, my degenerate friend, 4.7 overall score out of 10. So not doing very well on the ESG scale.
This is akin to you getting a score. You think you have a score of maybe 700. You know, for your credit score, and all of a sudden you find out that you have a score of 300. What are you going to be able to buy? How are you going to get a loan? Are you going to be able to buy a car, a house, or anything else? This credit score is going through the financial sector and the banks, and you'll understand why this is so bad here in a second. So when you get this, it is based on things from Merrill Lynch on the companies that you are buying. So if you want to buy stock and you think guns are going to be great and they're going to go up, they have a very low, what's called ESG score, environmental, social justice, and governance score.
So what'll happen is if you don't act accordingly, you lose points on your score. So when you try to get something like a car or whatever you're a threat to society. Yeah, right. So you lost money. Yeah, it's they're trying to push it. It's called an ESG score, an environmental, social, government, governmental score. So just the same way, like your credit's good, like yeah.
Score is down.
Right. So any job that you have, like if your job requirement, like for put it this way, let's go into environment. So. You're a crabber, right?
Right.
So let's say that you're going out there, you're going crabbing. Well, you're obviously burning gases and emission, you know, burning off emissions into the government. So right. You're going to lose a couple points there because that's
it's
your job.
It's not safe for your peers around
right,
you.
Right, because you're actually taking part in destroying the environment to get a profit. So we're going to take a little bit of points from you right there. Now, your social score, you incited some kind of fucking, you went in Facebook jail three times.
I'm in Facebook jail right now.
I'm just saying. So let's say you're in Facebook jail. You went to Facebook jail three times, so you lose points for that.
That's
you
know so what I'm saying? Stupid. Like, if that's how they're going to judge you, then why the fuck are all y'all crooked politicians going to lose
China,
every crunch y'all
in
got?
China, there is a social score system in place, and people rat each other out. That they've been testing these things in China. Yes. They've been testing all this shit in China and then they're trying to implement it here. All those big tech companies.
Remember when I told you about the general supposed we made that the invisible cloak.
Yep.
So all of those companies right out there, Google, Facebook, Twitter, they all are invested in China, and China basically let them do whatever they want because China can use that information for their control to control their people. So they let them test all of this shit. They're trying to implement that in the United States. They're trying to the whole 5G, like out there, 5G, there's fucking towers on every block. And so they could basically scan you in real time, just walking down the street.
And, like, that's another thing. Like, people were saying, oh, the 5G towers gave me COVID. No, it didn't. No, it didn't. I don't believe this. Because, look, if that was the case, then at birth, the doctors have planted an antenna in your body for you to catch 5K. I mean, 5G. Right, you know what I'm saying? That don't make sense. There's no 5G towers giving you coronavirus. You know what I'm saying?
Unless yeah, they were saying they could zap you with it. That was a conspiracy.
How are they going to zap you if you're not a conductor?
There's one thing that I've watched, and I watched this on a gardening channel. It wasn't even a conspiracy theorist channel. Is that the 5G towers, the radiation and stuff is so powerful that it's screwing up the direction. Like the birds need the magnetic field
too,
to control them to be able to migrate. And know it, and it's fucking up the equilibrium, and they dying and shit. They getting lost. I also seen that
on whenever I guess the axis shifts. Whenever you know the Earth, you know it's on its axis, and when it shifts, it messes up the poles because you know they're used to being here for so long.
Shift, right.
And when it shifts, it's like the magnetic, I guess, fields in the world change. Also, birds lose their sense of direction. You know,
I mean, what kind of shift are we talking about here?
I mean,
because
I don't know how. Like, all right, Earth's huge, right? You know what I'm saying? It could be an inch shift, or it could be a centimeter shift. It just depends on how big the shift is, because it is huge. So that little impact could be so much.
Oh, you know what I'm saying?
Because it's so big.
When they say, remember the 2012 word was going to end?
Yeah, I don't believe in that shit.
That was one. That was why they said it was going to be a pole shift.
I'm coming home, Dusty.
So, the poles were going to shift.
Yeah. So north would have been south. South would have been
right.
North. That would have been
and
a,
that would have
that would have been dead, totally
complete. It would have annihilated the entire planet and. There was a conspiracy.
Well, not completely, because what happened was, you know,
well, it would
south would have, you know, went north. So, us, where we're at now, our subtropical
climate
would be.
But what happened is we would have killed it, the natural disasters would have been unreal. And, humanity may have survived, but it was going to annihilate the planet.
Think about this. All right. Say that would happen. Antarctica is huge, right? It's freaking huge.
It would be, yeah.
But you really don't know how big it is to after all the ice caps melt on there. It could be as big as America, or it could be bigger or smaller. You really don't know. So whenever it changes, think about it. Fuck it. Just hop on board.
And in Antarctica, back they say thousands of years ago, it was actually a tropical climate. Before...
The first ice age or some shit.
Ice age, right. It actually, from climate change, it became what it is today. And there's just a huge ice sheet on top of God knows what. They say this the bottom, whatever, the Antarctica, the South Pole, in the middle, there's a huge hole, bro. I've heard a conspiracy. There's a whole underground world under there, bro.
They made a movie about that with The Rock in it.
What is that?
That is the Peck Pop of Love.
That was a pretty good movie.
The Journey to the Center of the Earth. Yeah,
something
like that.
There is a real report of old dude driving that plane. And
it was a guy in the military, right? Yeah. He flew over it. And he ended up going
in it.
Right. And they gave him, they told him that they've been watching, you know, they kind of covertly running the planet, I think it was. And there's a whole
race world within the center.
Inside the center of the planet.
I watch Ancient Aliens. I watch a lot of travel history shit. I'd be on that shit. That's just me. You know what I'm saying?
Well, so I've been on my thing. I've been a UFO nut for a long time, and I knew they exist. To me, I felt they were. It's a real thing. It just makes sense. So why would we the only intelligent life in all of the universe?
Right, we're the only anomaly.
That's just stupid. I think that's egotistically stupid. That's dumb to even think that.
Man, they're finding planets upon planets upon planets upon planets.
So
right now.
Now the military's actually coming out and admitting that UFOs are real. Finally.
Hey, good morning. The Pentagon has confirmed the authenticity of the newly leaked video and images showing those multiple UFO sightings by the U.S. Navy personnel.
I can confirm that the referenced photos and videos were taken by Navy personnel. The Unidentified Aerial Phenomena Task Force has included these incidents in their ongoing examinations.
The Defense Department, let's put this up there on the screen, has confirmed a leak video of an unidentified aerial phenomena that they say is real.
We spent some time reporting on this story. We should have spent a lot more time.
because this could be the most consequential thing to happen to this country, to this world, maybe ever. In June, the United States government is set to release a public report on everything it knows about UFOs. Lou Elizondo is the former head of the Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program. He's been on the show a number of times. He just spoke to the New York Post about what that report will show. According to Elizondo, we will find an intelligence failure on the part of the U.S. intel community on the level of 9/11.
The last time we had an intelligence failure of this country, a major one, which was 9/11, it took us almost 3 years to come up with the 9/11 Commission report. Okay, takes a long time. Let's just go down the rabbit hole here for a second. Let's just assume this is some sort of adversarial or foreign technology that several decades now has managed to leapfrog us and evade all 18 members of the intelligence community, despite our best human intelligence, signals intelligence, imagery intelligence, yada, 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 right? That would be an intelligence failure that would eclipse just about anything else this country has ever faced, especially if this has occurred for decades, that there's a foreign adversary that can put a nuclear warhead within moments over Washington, D.C. Okay, that's a problem.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Like whenever Trump got in office, why he was doing a Space Force if there was nothing there.
Yeah.
Space Force, like what are you scared of?
Well, he said they claim that it's just to keep up with, because like, the space race in other nations, the other, you know, like Russia and China, to be able to compete with them because they're doing it. Yeah. So that's why he created it. But then there's also a conspiracy saying that there's always been a space force.
How do you keep something secret? You hide it in plain sight.
There have been ET visitation, and people have been attempting to conceal this knowledge.
We actually did recoveries of bodies that were involved with some of these crashes.
I said, well, are you going to tell the public about it? And he says, no, we don't tell the public about this.
There began to be this bifurcation, this separation between legitimate national security and military operations and the deep black programs that are unacknowledged. If people think that it's just the UFO issue, they're gravely mistaken.
This is one of the ultimate secrets that needs to be exposed.
If there was a project that was illegal, the president doesn't know it's occurring, who's going to stop this from happening?
All right.
Yeah, it's always been the Space Force.
But he's finally coming out, but he's creating one because he wants the public should know about it. So they have to desensitize the public to this stuff. They can't just tell you everything that's going
on. What I want
to
know is, what's the military training behind the Space Force? Like, all right, I know, you know, everybody has to go to basic, but there's different branches in the military.
I don't know,
like,
right, what's the requirement?
Shoot you up in the...
Your basic space training, where is it going to be? In space. Your advanced space training, where is it going to be? Space. Benefits, who cares? You're going to space. All right? Assignments, what do you think, dude? You're going to space. So how about you just sign this contract?
Face,
you know, like a
like,
Navy SEAL. Yeah, like, what do I have to do?
Right.
What do I need to be in the Space Force? You understand?
I feel like maybe you had to be already in the military special operations or some like high class type shit and be like, all right, we're going to put you in this, I guess, I don't know. Like,
so
team
check
type
this
shit.
Out. So let's go. Did you see the videos that the military put out?
This video shows three triangle-shaped UFOs, which were filmed from the deck of a U.S. Navy craft, which was taken with cell phone video and was reported in 2019.
Like that admitted were real, like the UFO footage?
Oh, what, like the lights and stuff that recently came
the
out?
The green, yeah, right, yep, with the night footage, yep. Okay. And then the other one that kind of looked like a Batman.
Yeah.
They reportedly hovered just 700 feet above the stern of the Navy destroyer. Other cell phone images taken by a Navy pilot flying near Australia in March 2019 show three unidentified crafts reportedly performing extraordinary capabilities, like staying stationary in high winds.
Like, this is new stuff that just recently they're admitting that's real, and it's some of the best pictures of UFOs that we've ever seen.
Yeah.
they're telling you that it's real.
Yep.
By them admitting
the FBI
there's something
released
going
video
on.
Footage of now, UFO.
Now here's the tricky part about this is that we've recreated that technology since the 50s. And we've been hiding it from
since
the public.
Roswell, right?
There's a black budget program that's been in place for all these years, and they've been back engineering this alien technology.
Yes.
And so a lot of the UFOs that we're seeing are really all American or really, of this planet.
This is us, our test subjects, basically.
Right, but it's recreated, you know, like those triangle ones.
Yeah.
Those are called the TR-3Bs. These are actually experimental planes that they admitted they were working on in the 80s, and they acted like they stopped working on it. Yeah, they're these triangles, and they got these white lights on each corner of the triangle. In the middle, they got a little red light on them. And people see them all the time. Like, I've seen many videos of them. And what it is just recreated technology, you know, that's made in America.
America is still the land of rugged individualists. Like a rock,
I'm as strong as I could be. Like a rock.
Right. It's the black budget program.
It's like, all right, Roswell crash, you know, like they...
But what they're trying to desensitize us to this stuff and by putting it out there. Now, check this out. But in the same sentence, they're acting, you know, we don't know where this came from. Because technically, think about this. If, you know, these things are flying over, not just flying over our neighborhood, they're flying over military bases. Some of the strongest weaponry like that we have, like the nuclear, where all the nuclear rockets at and shit, they're flying over that. And they fucking with, because that's the best weapons we have. And they're toying with the best weapons we have, showing them that y'all can't, basically letting the military know that we can destroy you if
like,
we want to.
Like
picking on them.
Like, we are right in front of your strongest weapon.
Right, what you gonna do about it? Like picking on you and not doing it, because if they wanted to kill us, they would have done it already. You know what I'm saying?
Like, think about but that. They just, like, the technology that they have to even do space travel.
Right, and now here's
not
the deal.
Not even weaponry, just space travel.
But here's the thing. They're doing that because they want to scare the public to thinking that there's another boogeyman that's gonna kill us, and they want to do an alien, like stage a fake alien attack on the planet, like an Independence Day thing, to try to create the one world government. That's another conspiracy that's out there. That's the next war. Like, we had World War One, World War Two, the war on terrorism. The next one is a threat from outer space.
That's going to be the next thing.
Basically, a zoo compared to other species and stuff.
That's
basically,
like,
yeah.
We're
right.
Lesser. And,
absolutely.
And another thing, I think the Bible is a whole science project.
I don't believe in the Bible, if that makes sense. I mean, I believe in Jesus, I believe in God, but I don't believe in what's written in it, because if you read it, it's all metaphors, so you gotta interpret it the way that you interpret it. You see what I'm saying?
So when we talk,
like, no offense to anybody who,
no.
You know
I
what I'm saying?
Tell
like,
you.
Just my experiences. I don't believe. All right.
So here's
like
the issue with the Bible that people think that everything that's in there is the whole word, the truth, nothing
right,
but the
it's
truth
metaphors.
To every God. Now it's and what happened is that's the 44th version of the Bible. If people
right.
don't really understand that Bible was fought
and
over
and rewritten,
stomped on, right? So things were pulled out, added in. So but not saying that there's not fundamental truths in there, because there really is. Reading the Bible can change, you know, it's a life changing book. But is it the whole truth, nothing but the truth? No, it's not. You get what I'm saying? But there's a lot of great things that you can get out that book. You know,
definitely.
It's all about how
yeah.
you absorb the information.
Like I said, it's metaphors.
Every religion has that. Every religion has something
Wait,
great
let me
about
rephrase
it.
That. All right. Me saying I don't believe in the Bible is a little too far. I don't believe in the way that it is worded. and it makes you think. You see what I'm saying? Like, all right, we took your boy to rock bottom. He got swallowed by a whale. Now, what human being do you know that can physically be swallowed by a whale? Now,
right, you think
metaphorically, all cold? Right, rock bottom, it's like me being swallowed by a whale and going to the bottom of the ocean.
Right.
Now, if you live your life metaphorically, I feel that you would see it differently than being like, all right, he got swallowed by a real whale.
Swallowed by a whale.
Oh, he was turning to a burning bush. Oh, no, he was talking to a burning bush.
It got worse.
No, he might have a vision. Or a kind of like deja vu, or
cause I'm having deja vu here.
Something like in that kind of aura where
it's a work
or
of art.
You know what I'm saying? Like
it's a work
it's
of art.
It's just stories on stories.
It was written, and then it was written that way for a reason because human beings.
Because he wanted you to interpret it a certain way. Well, like he wanted you.
They wanted us to absorb it.
Exactly. I believe in I believe in a third eye though too though. Like
they wanted us to absorb it, and the thing is human beings love mystery.
Adventure, my dear Watson.
Human beings love adventure. Love excitement.
Right.
And that's why it was written that way. It was written that way so we would be intrigued by it. As different levels of Christianity, like because everybody sees it just a little bit different. But at the end of the day, to me, is the golden rule: is you treat others how you want to be treated. You know what I mean?
Like, I mean, like at the end of the day, like I feel like that's how it always should be, because if you treat somebody
things
with respect,
will be a lot easier, right?
If you treat somebody with respect or with mutual respect, you know what I'm saying? Like you're gonna get that in return.
It's like, so simple
to me. Like everything's built off relationships and who you know and how good you know them. You see what I'm saying? So like. If you treat a stranger with respect, well, that stranger ain't got no reason to, you know, come at you any certain way.
Right.
Like, he's going to treat you with respect.
We're flawed human beings. And what keeps us grounded is empathy. So, like, you know, what keeps you from getting out the car in the midst of a traffic jam and fucking grabbing somebody out of the truck and beating the shit out of them.
Back in the car, faggot.
Just having empathy, like, how would you know?
How would I feel if somebody,
did that to
I got
me.
My son in my car or something, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly. Like, so that's what keeps us grounded. That's what keeps us.
You get what you give, I guess.
Yeah.
Basically.
So you
like
treat
karma,
others treat others how you want to be treated.
Message!
And we're flawed, so you're going to run in. No matter what you do with the human race, there's always going to be some bad that comes with it.
Always, every freaking action got a reaction. Yeah.
But you know but I think it's as long as we are together,
we gotta adapt. Like you
the majority,
said,
right.
gotta adapt to our environment.
The only way we're gonna be able to move on and is to be able to sit down and have open conversations and be able to be in the same room with each other. And until we do that, we
bring it back up. Jordan Lucas, you know what I'm saying? I'm not racist. That video to me had more impact emotionally. To me, at least, just to see those visualizations of what his picture was depicted. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Really what it meant is that he's saying all these hateful and meanful words, like how he's saying it, but he's letting you know he's not racist. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, and at the end of the video, you know what I'm saying? Like, they hugged it out. Like, they settled their differences right there at that round table. And that's why it was a round table, I think.
Well, because you know everything that they thought about each other,
they laid it all out on the table. That's what that was about.
It was two different stereotypes,
two different worlds,
and none of them were, and none of the things that they thought about each other
was
true at all.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? They just thought that way because they were trained to be that way.
Exactly.
You don't.
It's like they were designed.
Yeah,
to be
you
like
just wasn't
this.
Born that way. People program that shit in your head.
Like,
you look at the terrorists. They training kids at 4 and 5 years old, whatever, to be a terrorist. And to that day, you're gonna die. You literally commit suicide.
Right. It's basically like you living to
Die. To commit suicide, right. Not just die. You're living to commit suicide because you think that you're going to get this, this, and this the day you do
it. I grew up getting told, like, if you commit suicide, that's a selfish act and that you would go to hell. These people, they think they're going to offense to, you know what I'm saying? I mean, whatever your religion is.
Like, you're dying for the cause.
But it's like as if you're taking your life, like you say, for the cause. But what's the cause? Like, you could have had a different future, or, you know what I'm saying? Like, yep.
Well, and the issue is like, because those are, they're looking for love through, they're looking for purpose through external sources. Like, by committing suicide, when I do this,
I got 50 all virgins. Of
this is going to come to me. Like, right. I'm going to find paradise. I'm going to find peace if I do this.
That's your key to heaven, basically. Well,
and the real talk is like, true inner peace comes from inside. True peace.
Exactly.
You're not going to be able to be, you know, like, find until love you, until you love yourself. Peace with yourself. Right.
Exactly.
Right. You can never do those things.
Message.
The material world, it's cool to have, you know, nice things. It's cool to have, but it's not the end all be all. It doesn't make or break you. It's not the truth. It's not all. It's all cracked up.
And that doesn't, like, whatever stuff you got or whatever, that doesn't determine who you are. Like, let that be known.
Absolutely.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they could have the most richest person with all the good shit, and his life would just be total just miserable. Shit.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And, like, people don't realize that they just look, like, it's basically like you on the outside looking in. Like,
right.
You really don't know what's going on inside the house because you're not in there. You're just on the outside.
All these material things, they cool. They're tools. Let's get to work. It's great to have technology. It's great to have tools. Great to have the newest, coolest things, but they're only tools to get a job done. You know what I'm saying? They're not necessities. They don't make or break you. They're not the end all be all.
Think about this: if we didn't have iPhones or computers, what would we do to get in contact with other human beings? A letter. You know what I'm saying? Like,
if you want to get in touch with somebody bad enough,
you'll go over there.
You're gonna do it.
Right, like I don't know. I just feel like whenever these smartphones and computer shit and media got to how it is now,
it's
like they done cut you off from being social with, like, another human being, like how we are. So that's basically, boom, a pandemic right there on its own. Just by cutting you off from, like, the real world.
Yep.
Now you subject to just know what's going on TV or on that phone or on that computer.
Well, and...
So you don't leave your house, so now you don't really know what's going on in the real world, so you have no choice but to believe what's being told to you.
Yeah, you know, and people fall into that trap, and it's a day of instant gratification, bro. Like, you know, instant results. We want things right on the spot, and there's so much information being flooded at us through this phone.
Exactly. It's endless.
It's way too much for us to absorb. So we probably get like 0.1% of anything that we absorb from that thing that day.
Social skills went down.
Because so much going on, bro. Oh, for sure.
Social everything, skills down.
Everything.
Negative.
Yep. The intelligence levels are going to go down. Like, you don't need to calculate anything.
Now,
you got it in your hand.
Like, not just our kids, but say our kids' kids. All right, if we keep going in the route that we're going in, how are our kids' kids going to have any kind of social life? Well, all they know is a phone or a computer or just in their house. How are they going to date? How are they going to get, like, jobs? How are they going to have just a regular life? And deal with other people if they have to go shopping.
Well, so,
you know what I'm saying?
One thing I could say is that the technology's not going anywhere.
Oh, no.
It's here to stay.
Yeah.
So we have to find a way to make it work for us and not let it work us and not, you know.
Right.
And those things could be possible, but one thing is not going anywhere, so we have to find a way to live in peace with it and be able to control it. Like, let it be understood that it can dominate your life.
on weekends after like 9 o'clock, it was like 3 minutes and shit. Like, that's like the era I grew up in. Yeah. Like, so like, I'm kind of like, you know, on that same
early,
kinda,
early internet days.
You know what I'm saying? Said like, you didn't have a GPS. Know where you was at, you was calling that
You go
person.
Online, you Google and print it out. Yeah. And then you got a little pamphlet with
that
you tells you how to get there.
Man.
Yeah.
Like, that was
back then you had to write it down. You know what I mean? We had to write that shit down. That's how we found out. We could, and then if we had to make a phone call, you got to find the nearest payphone and pull over and make a phone call.
Yeah, you can't even find a payphone. That's like history.
Gentlemen, we're history.
Oh, you ain't
finding like something that's like ancient history, you know?
Right. You ain't finding no payphone today.
Kids today are like, what's a payphone? That's like if I ask him, man, this car got a cassette player back in his day. It was badass.
Just wait till you hear how fantastic Sanyo makes my cassette sound.
The Sanyo's unbelievable. Auto reverse, metal tape.
The great sound of Sanyo car stereo brings people together for the better life.
Sanyo!
And they're like, what's a cassette player? And I'm like, are you serious?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like... And just you can. There's so much power in that phone. Like it even makes the desktops are not even needed. For, you know what I mean? Like you gotta have a real reason to go to your desktop. You know what I mean?
Like if you're not like printing a picture or something,
right?
What you need?
Pretty soon you can run a whole studio outside on your phone.
Hey, you GarageBand.
Almost do it right now, right?
GarageBand.
Pretty soon, yeah. The technology is gonna be that dope. Pretty much a studio on your fucking phone.
And, like, phones got smarter, but people have got, like, stupider or dumber. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to say stupid.
Well, yeah, because the less, you're not challenging yourself.
You don't have
yourself.
To learn everything.
Right. You,
it's
you
right
don't have to
you.
Do it. You don't have to absorb it. So you're not going to do anything, your brain's just not going to need that. Yeah. The aliens that evolved and their heads grew really big because they got big brains and the little body, you know, like the little gray aliens with the big fucking heads.
Yeah.
We're gonna be the opposite way. We're gonna have little bitty head. Fucking marble heads, bro.
Exactly. Our brain was gonna shrink because we're not thinking for ourselves. This phone's thinking for you. You know what I'm saying?
The ultimate the devil.
It really is, man. Like, I mean,
we got the devil in our pocket
always, and you know it's listening 24/7 recording.
So you got a new album coming out, don't you?
Oh yeah, album coming out. I'm not gonna tell y'all a specific day because I want it to be a surprise for y'all, and either one or two more weeks it'll be out. The first week of May for sure, but I got a bunch of nice projects on there that y'all like, so you know.
How many songs on?
I was planning for 17, but there might be 18, 19, depending on if I'm gonna give y'all some of this new music I've been recording. But who knows? I might even give y'all two versions of it. It might be a SoundCloud edition, and then it might be like an actual album edition.
There you go.
So you know, you got two versions of the same album, but it's different at the same time. If it makes sense.
Yes. I don't get it.
Yeah, no, that makes a whole lot of sense.
I give y'all like an album on iTunes and Spotify, which is the actual album, and then I might drop something along with it the same day. You never know.
Right.
Just be on the lookout.
Well, peace. See ya. Yeah, we're going to get together soon, homie.